Okay, here we are, part two of chipping with Rick Pruitt. And this is Bob Cunningham, GeorgiaGolfGuru.com. And Rick, your company and background, tell us a little bit about you again.
Well, I'm retired from sales management from Sara Lee Coffee and Tea, food service coffee business for a long time, retired. Wanted to stay active. I like sales, I like promoting items, I like promoting people. So I got involved in online marketing, basically social media marketing. And the company I'm with now, I'm a social media marketer with WebTalk.
What's the name of your company?
WebTalk. WebTalk.
And your marketing company is called?
Rick Pruitt.
Oh, that's a novel name.
Yeah,
I can remember that. Well, I've learned a lot about marketing. Untold is unsold, and I come from a sales background. My wife, her whole background is teaching, her whole family. I've never taught, but actually, teaching is selling. An idea, communicating, and I hope we're doing a good job and we'll continue. I hope you're all watching. And if you're interested, intrigued by what we're doing, push the little subscribe button and the bell will give you notifications. So I've got 252 videos on YouTube, so it's out there, it's free. Please gather around. We're going to be doing some other things. It's going to be in the market. So, setting up here, we moved back because we were right in the first video, we were very near the. And actually, in essence, you should be putting from that area. Your worst putt is generally better than your best chip. But the idea is we want this to roll like a putt as soon as it can get on the surface. So we want maximum ground time, minimum air time. If I'm throwing something to a wall, we don't want it going high. We want to have it just a gentle arc. And the same way with the golf swing. So. Let me explain how chip works. One of these has a line. Yeah, this has a line. So understanding is a big part of. So there's a line here. A lot of people, and I hear this, draw a line of the magic marker through the middle of the ball, and that represents the equator. If this ball is like the Earth, northern hemisphere, southern hemisphere, equator line. So what we want is this club to come through at below the equator line slightly. Then it rolls up to the fifth scoring line, and that gives the backspin. And it just depends on how much force we want to give it. And I'm a top level pool player, so I want very good speed control to the ball. And I think I asked you before, Rick, what's more important? They're both important in putting and chipping, distance or direction?
Without a doubt, distance.
You're absolutely right. So keep that in mind, guys and gals. So Rick is going to demonstrate a good chipping. There's a lot of ways to chip, a lot of ways to putt, but there are some that are more effective and efficient. So we're going to go for efficiency. So talk your way through it. What are you doing?
Well, number one, before I want to land the ball, right, a little bit right. I want to land 2 feet left. I want to get it on green too quick.
Yeah.
Get it out of this. Oh, get it on green too quick. Pick a spot about 4 or 5 paces.
Yeah. Now, when you do that, you're mindful, there's a top edge and there's a bottom edge. Mm-hmm. This flares out the top, so we don't look at that, we look at the bottom.
Right.
And this is like a T-square, so we have to be very careful what angle we have it pointed. If you're 2 degrees open, it's going to go right across, conversely, close.
Okay.
Yep.
Set the club first. I'm gripping it, I just said. Got it. Back on the stick. Lined up. Target a little bit
So that was a good chipping motion.
I do remember.
But we needed more energy transfer. Now, where's your weight transfer?
I mean,
it's on your left. So
set up there. Yeah. Get one more here. Then weight here.
And pressure, you're pushing down. Thin to wind, but a lot of times that stays on the green, but it can cause a lot of 3 or 4 shots to get down.
Should we do one more?
Okay. Well, you got kind of a mysterious light. See it, feel it, do it. Don't even think a whole lot about it. Do it. Okay, so that was a little less energy. Here's another ball. So now we want to go a little bit more left, a little more energy. So that's why we practice. We're using these shots. So let's set up. Our body's a machine, the club's a tool. My dad was a tool and die maker during World War II, working tolerance of a thousand. We didn't have to be that close. We need to be really mindful of the bottom edge. And that's a little open. It may not look like it. Now that almost a little bit long. Straight on, but we get sideways with the story. So for now, just exaggerate. That's looking good. So that you hit the ground first. So that is really rolling nice. So Rick demonstrated a lot of things what not to do, right?
Exactly.
Thank you. So what we want you to do is do as we say, don't do as we do. But as with practice, use it, you lose it this month. Yeah, you've been away from it with your marketing, so I can see some rust there. So we'll get you back on track. And just going back to basic fundamentals of mechanics, you'll soon get there. So I want to thank you. Later. Cheers. Be safe. Be well. This is the Ancient One signing off.